You are now listening to the MAS Show, the hottest sports broadcast on the planet. On today's show, Anthony Carter interviews Indianapolis Colts beat writer for the Indianapolis Colts, Kevin Bowen.
All right, thank you for listening to the MAS Show. With me today on the show is Indianapolis Colts beat writer for the Indianapolis Colts, Kevin Bowen. Good afternoon, Kevin. How are you?
Doing good, Anthony. How are you?
I'm great. So, Kevin, this season, Reggie Wayne tore his ACL and is done for the season. How important is it for guys like T.Y. Hilton and other receivers on the Colts to step up now that Reggie is out?
Vital. Reggie meant so much to this offense. Like every time on a third down, that's where Andrew Luck would turn to. 287. He's done it here now for 13 years. He's got a Hall of Fame resume. Personally, I think he's a guy that you can count on catching 100 balls and 1,000 yards every year. When you take that out of your offense, it's a vital component considering the offense has already lost four offensive starters for the year before Wayne tore his ACL on October 20th against the Broncos. So, Hilton has been a guy that Andrew Luck has turned to on third down. Griff Whalen, his college teammate, was an undrafted free agent in 2012. He's been a guy that Luck has looked to on third down as well, made some critical catches last night in Nashville in the comeback victory. LeVon Brazil is another guy, another second-year receiver. There are a lot of second-year skill players on this offense. LeVon Brazil is a guy that's going to have to step up moving forward. Gary Taylor Bay, I think the Colts are still trying to look for consistency out of him. He hurt his ankle last night, but he wasn't really available in the second half. And then I think you saw Kobe Fleener really coming out party for the another one of Luck's college teammates. He was the first pick in the second round in 2012 and hit a career high last night. I believe he had 8 catches, over 100 yards receiving, both career highs for Fleener. So I think moving forward, Hilton, Fleener, Waylon, those are your 3 main guys. And I think the Colts are still hoping for Hayward Bay and Lamar Brazil to get their hands in the mix as well.
You're right. Kobe Fleener has definitely improved. Last night, linebacker Eric Walden headbutted Delanie Walker from Tennessee when Delanie Walker had his helmet off. Have you heard anything on what the NFL will do with this situation?
No, it looks like the NFL is going to wait until this weekend's play of games is over before they make a ruling on Walden. I mean, obviously not a smart play. It was really just a ton of foolish plays from the Colts on that late or on that mid-second quarter drive. You had a personal foul on Ryan Fitzpatrick. You almost had another personal foul when Fitzpatrick was running out of bounds. You had a pass interference penalty, and then obviously Walden's penalty kind of topped it off. So he's definitely fortunate that the refs didn't see it. He could have been kicked out of the game, but I assume a fine will come his way. I haven't heard anything yet, though, so it's just speculation at this point, but I think you will hear something early next week, and we'll go from there.
All right. Also, last night, Donald Brown racked up 2 TDs in a win against the Titans. Do you think the run game has improved with Trent Richardson and Donald Brown?
I think last night was definitely the highlight, since really Richardson and Brown have been the main combo moving forward. Brown had 14 carries for 80 yards in Nashville last year in the Colts overtime win, which a lot of people remember for Vic Ballard's kind of leap into the end zone, but it was Brown who really set up that touchdown in the overtime as the Colts started with the ball. And last night, it was really Brown in the second half, again, his coming out party for the 2013 season, 14 carries, another 80 yards. Both those touchdowns, those are career high. He's never had 2 touchdowns in a game before. So I think you are seeing the Colts offensive line kind of starting to gel a little bit. It's been baby steps. Chuck Pagano said after the game that they were on a mission this week. They wanted to prove some people wrong. They've been under a lot of criticism in and around the Indy area, just from the local media here and the national media. So I think they were able to open up some holes. And Brown serves as a nice compliment to Richardson. Richardson is kind of a power guy who I think is still trying to find his groove here in Indy. But while he's kind of between the tackles guy, Brown has a quick burst. I think they are a good complement to each other, similar to what you saw maybe earlier in the year with Amon Bradshaw and Donald Brown. But yeah, it was really nice to see Donald, the guy who's been here for 5 years. He's kind of had an up and down career after being the first round pick in 2009. He's awarded a game ball last night by Chuck Pagano, and you can tell his teammates really embraced him upon receiving that. And I think you can just really tell how much he means to this team. He's a guy that is a kind of a pillar guy. He's just kind of alludes to the guys that have been here for a while. Coach said last night, you know, he's one of those guys that's first to get in here and last to leave. So nice to see Donald have a great game out on Thursday night. And I think for this Colts offense to really get things going, get off to better starts and make any type of run in January, you will need to see Richardson and Brown play at a high level.
Right. All right. Well, we're going to go to a quick music break. We still have more Colts coming up.
When you said it was over, you shot right through my heart. Why you let these wolves tear what we had right apart? Oh, I was so mad. I could have seen this coming right from the start. You should beware, beware, beware. Love a woman with a broken heart. Praying to a sky all black. Looking at the stars like they finna talk back. Whoa. Looking at my phone like she finna call back. Whoa. But last night I feel like probably ended all that. Cause by now she would've sent a text in all caps. Then another one trying to take it all back. Saying, fuck you, I miss you, or I hate you so much. Cause girls only say I hate you to the guys that they love. I know, I know, I know. The highs, the lows, it comes, it goes. You say be real, I try, I don't. Cause you take anything and just make it everything. Kept my phone on silent ever since you got a ring. Funny, right? And I never cheated. I mean, maybe once, twice. One time don't change everything. She asked why I don't feel the same. I'm still the same. She's still insane, and now she's saying.
You said it was over. You shot right through my heart. Why you let these wolves tear what we had right apart? Ooh, I'm so mad. I could have seen this coming right from the start. You should beware, beware, beware of a woman with a broken heart.
Okay, ski, smoke, sleep, call, miss, text, woke, spoke, lie, feel, Lisa, ill, time, kill.
All right, if you're just joining us, I have Kevin Bowen on to talk Colts. So, Kevin, Robert Mathis is currently leading the league in sacks at 13.5. How well do you think he is playing in Greg Minuski's defense?
Well, I think Mathis has been, it's up a career year for him. 13.5 sacks is a career high for him, and to do it, you know, only after, I guess now you play 10 games, it's pretty impressive. He's definitely right around pace for the NFL record, Michael Strahan, 22.5.
Right.
It's just special to see Mathis do this without Dwight Freeney on his side. I think a lot of people thought for a lot of years that it was kind of Freeney absorbing a lot of double teams, and that's what allowed Mathis to have Pro Bowl-type numbers, but he's shown this year that he's really been a one-man wrecking crew in terms of the Colts' pass rush, and he's 2.5 sacks away from a single-season record for the Colts. Freeney had 16 sacks in a season, and he's also 2.5 away from the franchise record, which is 107.5. So, I think Mathis is closing in on both those. You know, hopefully he can stay healthy. Last night he really didn't have any great chances, I think, of Fitzpatrick, but you know he's going to get some other opportunities as the year goes on, and been a huge asset for this defense. Just some timely play, none bigger than on October 20th when he sacked Manny in the end zone, forced that fumble, which the Colts turned into a safety, and that kind of spearheaded, it goes 23 straight points out of the Colts. So he's been a game record for this team, and you can't just say enough about his leadership as well. He's the, you know, by far the longest tenured player on the Colts defense besides Antoine Fessette. So Mathis has been huge for this team, and fast rushing prowess is definitely one of the big play abilities that this Colts defense has.
Right. With Chuck Pagano being the head coach of the Colts this year, how do you think Chuck Pagano is like a great aspect to this Colts team?
Yeah, I think definitely. I think everything that he went through last year has been well documented, and you still see the Chuck strong shirt kind of being worn around. Around the building and around this team, and just a great motivator from everything that I've gathered. And I think this team just really loves playing for him and really loves, you know, trying to go out there for 60 minutes, stick to the process, never judge, and don't really look at the scoreboard. I think that has been indicative of this team. Yes, you need to get off to better starts, and Chuck Pagano will be the first one to tell you that, but the team is never out of a game. Just huge comebacks against, you know, the Texans and the Titans, and you've pretty much locked up the AFC South, and that's because this team has never quit, never attitude and resilient bunch, and I think it comes from the head coach. And I think Chuck has been 14-2, I want to say they are, in one possession games under Pagano. So, I mean, that is very, very impressive. And I think if this team, you know, has a chance to make a run in the playoffs, it is built to do that, even with those injuries, considering they are both kind of as a run-first team. Chuck Pagano knows that he has to travel to a road venue in the playoffs. It's probably not going to be great weather if you've got to go to Foxborough or Denver or Kansas City. So being able to run the football and play some good defense is what this team needs to do. And I think they are showing signs of both that. Hopefully get Greg Toler starting quarterback next week against Arizona, and this defense can take another step, as they did play much better after the first few drives last night, limiting Chris Johnson, and then really kind of keeping momentum on the Colts side of the ball.
Right. All right. Well, Kevin, I would like to thank you for being on our show today. Is there anything else you'd like to say before we go?
Not at all, Tony. I appreciate you being on, and yeah, hoping Colts can make a run deep into January and early February.
Right. We'll see. All right, everyone, that was Colts beat writer for the Indianapolis Colts, Kevin Bowen. You can follow him on Twitter @KBowenColts. Thank you for listening to the MAS show.